Dear friends of justice, I welcome you to today's special show with Professor Sucharit Bhakdi. I don't need to introduce him, dear Sucharit. Many heartfelt thanks for honoring me. You are one of the world's most famous infectious disease experts, and you have been in a very, very important, decisive phase of humanity, found the courage to do the right thing. You have put your whole reputation, your renown, you have put your entire life's work on the line for humanity, saving hundreds of thousands, if not simply saved the lives of millions of people. And for that, I am eternally grateful to you. Dear Sucharit, please, let's get to the point. It's about this Saturday, which is November 11th. There's a symposium at the German Bundestag, and you're going to perform there. And you have some explosive new insights, huh? That could be game-changing. Let's talk about it. What exactly is it about?
Yes, thank you, Jan. I have no new insights. New insights have emerged, and these insights have gained others. I'm just reporting on it in an understandable way so that people understand. Now it's crunch time. A game changer has been discovered, and that's what I want in the hall. Explain. An American, a genetic researcher, one of the really discovered it, right at the front. And what he did is he discovered that in these inclusives, fabric piles, bacteria chromosomes, or you need to let that sink in, are peckered so that when they are injected, they occur in you. Your cells will take in these foreign chromosomes. You are genetically modified, Jan, and anyone who that allows this to be done to him. It's genetically modified. How long that stays, I don't know. But to be genetically modified for a second is already a second too much. And there is absolutely conclusive evidence that, I mean, the walking that is being recorded in this.
That's it for today. See you next time. Bye.
Bacteria consumption is the gene for production of the virus spikes. Now you just have to imagine it. Yes, these mRNA vaccines, they are knockoff products of knockoff from the Book of Life by chromosome. That's DNA. Yeah. When DNA is needed, the Book of Life is opened where the recipe is. Then a print is made, and this print, you're in the RNA and go out to the bakery where the cake is baked or the protein is made. Jesus, protein, in this case spike, is then displayed on the windowsill. And when, if the protein belongs to you, then the cell that does that is left alone. If you make an uptouch from your own life book and a product, then it's fine. But if the product isn't from me, and I put the product on the windowsill, then comes the reboot. Count this around. Always, there's no escaping it. That's the immune system. And this gift is given at birth. Every baby does this. Yes, it may take a few days longer for the baby than for you and me, but it's coming. It's like graft rejection. You get my kidney, you reject my kidney. Immediately, no, not immediately, it takes days, but it works. If you commit the misdeed of getting my second kidney, then it will be rejected even faster. Those are the side effects. After the first shot, it takes a bit.
Until next time.
You're seriously ill. But after the second, third shot, you get sick faster and more seriously. Now, these RNA preparations, against coal. We are the first ever in the event that were made. And the question is, where did the Book of Life come from to make this imitation of the virus? And the answer is, in the beginning, the pharmaceutical industry and BioNTech, Pfizer, Moderna, the most advanced genetic technology is used. Because what can be done these days is, if you only have a relatively small amount of such, if chromosomes are needed, yes, then you can make them in a pot. Because you actually buy the ingredients, throw it in the pot, and then you press it on, and then it's controlled by the computer, this recipe made from DNA. And then you can just make a mold. And that's what BioNTech did for 20,000 people in 2020, when the first large clinical study was conducted. And all these agencies approved it, yes, to make it as a process. And then the whole thing was supposedly a success. That's a lie. It wasn't a success at all. But they fudged the numbers and said it works. And then they got the green light to inject millions of people with the fury. But it's too expensive to do it all in the cooking pot. So they went and put nature back on the plan. Animal chromosome. By the way, you can buy them because they are very small, yes? And they are very easy to these bacterial chromosomes. Unlike our chromosomes, you can actually introduce new gene with genetic engineering into the book of life of bacteria. And then do we put that back into the bacteria? Let the bacteria multiply, and they multiply like crazy. From one bacterium in 3 days, you have so many bacteria, you can't even count them. And these books, they too multiply with the foreign walking, which was put in. You knew that out from the bacteria, yes. Mass in the right place makes the imprint consultation. And that was given to humans. So, and the wonderful thing is, yes, that the farm industry is price retaining away and modern. They have taken this other manufacturing method without informing the people. And the authorities knew, but they approved it anyway. So the problem is, when you do something like this and you have bacterial chromosomes along with the nonsense copies, then you have to remove this chromosome before you put your product in and then give it into the body. Otherwise, that goes with it. And that's what McKernan discovered. And he saw that these vaccine batches he examined, it was early in the year, fully loaded with bacterial chromosomes, which were packaged in such a way that they'll get into your teeth. And then, of course, they are durable. Yes, chromosomes are durable, and you are changed every. And at first, the Germans said, yes, but it was an American damage size. But now all over the world, the same findings have been made, even in Germany. In all shells studied so far, a plethora of bacterial chromosomes have been found with the gene for the virus. And of course, that explains a lot, almost everything, why people are doing so badly. They are constantly deciding they are two targets for your own immune system. From head to toe, depending on where you are, where the walking ends up, in the brain, in the heart, in dignity. Now, after that became known,
game changer.
No one is allowed anymore. Not even Lauterbach is allowed to say that. It is safe and effective because now it is known that this vaccine is so uncertain, that must be banned immediately. And whoever the doctor who injects this back into a body must know that he, if the contamination is there, and until now the contamination has been found in all 27 batches that have been investigated, also selected, if the doctor doesn't know that the batch is not contaminated and injects it with the knowledge that there's a chance he could genetically modify a person, may God be with him, may God be with him. And when a politician, no matter which faction,
goal,
still supports the vaccination and tries to implement it, God be with him. And I call on Saturday that politicians from all party lines stand up and say, now we fulfill our duty to our people, we will protect them. Beware of them dying genetically, and whoever doesn't do that, I can only shake my head when people still continue to. If these people choose, then it's their own fault. Credit check construction.
Let's not
stop fighting each other more. The division is so deep, the trenches are so deep, and everyone can now. That's the positive. And I end on this positive note. It was not known until now
that this crime began.
This is indeed a crime which was obviously organized at the highest level, and the authorities were involved in it. It's your turn. The authorities are now on it. This is Paul Ehrlich Institute. This is Robert Koch Institute. This is the entire Federal Ministry of Health, Germany and the other countries. But the others,
also the medical profession, they are over.
The population is completely innocent, and the other politicians are also innocent, because nobody knew that. This is what I want to say.
Many thanks, Sucharit. I'll sum this up very, very briefly. It's the last chance for everyone involved to get their head out of the noose. Because you can now argue, we didn't know, but after this Saturday, after the 11th of November, you won't be able to argue like that anymore. And yes, it's therefore the last chance to switch sides, to come to us, because those who are responsible for this, it's a handful of people. It's very few, and you want to be with them. Allow me, with those you want nothing, to have something to do. Did I get that right to the point? Exactly.
Then, dear
friends of justice, dear friends of truth, thank you so much for being here. Try to spread this video as far as possible. You can also download it on TikTok or upload on X or on YouTube, on Facebook, everywhere, on your Telegram channels, or just share as you want. The 11th of November, 2023 will be an important day, and you can contribute. Thanks a lot. And see you next time, dear Sucharit. I thank you again. And goodbye.